can't believe that you want me to be me. And yeah, my production assistant is a cute boy. I don't want to show them what I was packing. I was very young. Now I'm not. Now I can do a new trick like this.
Yeah.
Photographer Monisha Ajgaonkar, founder of The Photo Diary, has collaborated with drag queen and activist Sushant Divgikr to create a coming-of-age photo series called Blossom. The duo recently spoke to Sunday Midday, and here's what they have to say.
Last month was the Pride Month.
Yeah.
So I've seen a lot of stories that, you know, a lot of transgender has been getting killed. Like, it's not they're committing suicide or anything. It's like people are going into their houses and killing them. So I thought creating a story, something regarding for the community and also for the trans people. So I thought, like, how one person should feel comfortable about himself and, you know, and just love yourself and you can just be whoever you want to be. It's one of those things that he came into my mind. It's just like, you know, sometimes you think of a story or something you want to shoot and you have someone's face. So it was his face. I messaged him on Instagram like, dude, I have this concept. He's like, yeah, gay. He didn't hurt or anything, he just said yes.
I'm so glad to know I was your muse. That's so sweet. But yeah.
What happened to you, you know, when she
I just loved the idea about, she sent me the reference shots and so I mean, I thought it's the reference for this is my first nude shoot.
Yeah, he forgot. I'm not doing it, I'm opening shot.
So she was just like, okay, come on, are you ready? I was like, no, I'm getting makeup. She's like, no, first shot you're naked.
Where did you meet up? Where did this conversation happen?
Just off, no, directly at the studio.
Oh, you're just traveling alone. And I met him once.
At one of my shows, at Kashish.
Yeah, but he was like caught up.
Yeah, and then, and so I wanted her essentially to meet my team and to explain to them, you know, what has to be done and stuff. And then also the team, so I think that we had kind of locked. So, but then I never thought that it was, I thought it's a reference shot, so I mean, you cheat, you're a photographer, you cheat, you know, not showing me nude and all of that. But then, like, so, and then she was like, but I sent you the reference shots, and that's a new photo. And I was like, yeah, I know, but you know, I'm very shy like that and stuff. So, but I was very comfortable with the whole team, the whole the unit was very, very nice and very forward thinking, I would have to say. Also, the styling was on point. Makeup was very, very good. Also, the theme was so beautiful, where it, like, you know, you're like this person who's been abused and you know, insulted and put down by the, you know, society. How he blossoms into this queen, you know? And it's very close to my heart because it's sort of my story. And I don't know, so I'm very glad that I did it because it's. It's Monisha, first of all, and she's quite a, you know, legend in her own might, I would say, and right. And I think that it's high time we kind of told stories that are real. So it's a very real sort of metamorphosis of this boy who was very too scared and in a shell. And well, I give credit to my dancer's body for bending like that. She was also like, how do you bend like this? It's not in my brief. Well, I'll give you a little sour bag.
Why was it important to capture the nude?
That's the main shot. You want like nude, like you're just like that. And
like that raw.
Yeah, and that's the thing. Like, he was not loving himself, not even his own body. So that's the main shot. Like, makes me showcase, like, you know.
So I think the first and the last shot were
the flowers.
Yeah.
That's
see, but then that's what you're blossoming into. Mm-hmm. So you know, first there's the root. And then, you know, the fur is growing out of his back. And that is when he's not, like, so close to the ground that he's not comfortable in himself. And then he sort of starts, you know, showing a little of his face. And then, you know, his body. And then, you know, half his face, which is like the queen. And then half of it is still without makeup. And I think that's that raw.
Mm.
And I thought that was great.
You shot somebody new. What was it?
Yeah, even this was my first
shoot. Yeah, correct. So, what was the experience like?
I was very excited. I was like, you go land it. I was like that.
She will obviously be excited. She has to click the picture. I was
like so ready because the lighting was done, everything.
And my production assistant is a cute boy. I don't want to show them what I was packing.
Yeah, I
can
show them.
Sorry. I'm Konkani, hello. I'm very orthodox. Look at this. Even in this weather, I'm wearing a jacket. So imagine stripping all of that and I'm like going like this. Is anyone watching? She's like, I could do remote task. It's just me. And I hadn't even waxed my legs. So
yeah, I was like, I have to wax my legs.
Couldn't make up more raw than that. Like my salon lady really slapped me. She was like, "Tum aaye the tabhi wax karna chahiyega." That broke a lot of my stereotypes of photography also. Wherein I thought that everybody doesn't go in me. You know, it's all done. Like, you know, it's just the face, and then you know maybe they kind of, you know, morph it, or I don't know what, they Photoshop it or something. So I saw the reference and then she was like, but you saw the reference. And I said, yeah, I did, but I can't believe that you want me to be me. I can't. She's like, now see, there's been booked the studio for so and so amount of time and now you have to start now.
Because you need to shoot with the story, but if you start with different things, like last year, this year, it just kills your vibe.
But she made sure that everybody left the room, so that was
So who was it? It was just this.
It was me and my documentary team that's doing the documentary. That guy was there, but he was taking it very artistically, like there was something in the middle, and then you couldn't see my bum or something. This one clicking away. And then you know, I was looking at it, then everybody's like, wow, very nice. I'm like, hi. And then she's like, yeah, but like the whole world is going to see it. What's wrong with you? And I'm like, yeah, I was very young. Now I'm not. Now I can do a new shoot like this. Like, this was one thing I wanted to do before my 30s, but like literally just before I turned 30. Not now. But I've been asked by a lot of international photographers to do new shoots and some very big, big photographers. And then I realized that we have one international gem sitting here only who I'm like literally doing it for. So I said that, you know, why not? The novelty to someone from the community, from India, and now she'll take these photos somewhere internationally. Let's see, put it on some matrimonial sites. Just like, you know, my God.
Was it liberating for you?
Like, it was very, honestly, I just felt, I shed in it all my inhibitions and my clothes, but I thought that it was just so enriching of an experience, and it's okay to be who you are and to be the body that you're in.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.